ego, the more unhappy, is an individual. Maybe I would have appeared to somebody very happy, but I wasn't happy at that time. I was only cribbing. Maybe I'm not doing so much as I used to do professionally. I'm doing probably better, but I'm more happier. So it again becomes very relative as we progress and we start understanding how important a word like ego can actually change a lot of day-to-day thinking and make you yourself a peaceful person. Because finally we all want peace. You want to be peaceful with yourself and with the society around you. And that's the most important thing. Whether you have money, you don't have money, wherever you come from, it's very important to be peaceful within. And that takes a lot of effort. It's not easy. When somebody comes and yells at me, I have to learn to keep quiet. Because that is a trait we have to understand. That it is him or her screaming. He is screaming his anger and his frustration out at me. I just become the victim. So if I am going to start reacting, all these losses start coming. So if an individual harbors thoughts such as my wealth, my body, then he becomes unhappy because the expectation is built only around those materialistic external things. Yes, I'm not denying wealth is required. Health is required. But at the same time, when certain things which are beyond your control, and after you have put in the efforts, I will not say don't put in efforts, because that again is wrong. God helps those who help themselves, and that's very true. If we put in that kind of efforts, but if I have met with an accident and if I have cut my limb, there is nothing I can do. Instead of saying, oh poor me, I am not going to do. We have seen, you know, we get all these emails, you know, for people. Yesterday I have received an email from, he's a Chinese. He doesn't have this part of his body. He doesn't have down. He's just got his body till here. That guy is entering a marathon, a walking marathon. And you keep looking at that picture, he's made two roads. He's there in Shenzhen. He's made two roads. And he's going to walk, the marathon. I mean, that is something what we have to look at, not something what we don't have. You know, and that's why the expectations what we built around our own selves have to be made less. Because we do expect a lot out of a person, a situation, when we meet people and so on, out of relationships. The mission undertaken by harboring ego is destroyed with the passage of time and not benefiting from making an offering. Saints believe that everything belongs to God and that they own nothing, and hence they are always in bliss. If you were to be given a clean slate as of today, leave everything, what is it that you would have? Would you left with? We have heard of so many stories of people where, you know, the houses break overnight and there's floods in Pakistan, has floods. 800 people have died. What happens? There are riots across in different parts of Europe. I've just come from Europe. Things are not very good there. And when you look at all these situations, you find that if the belief, if you change that basic premise of our life, and it's not easy, but it's not impossible. It is possible that everything what is given to you is only God's grace. Because if nothing is mine, whatever is coming to me is only God's. The whole thinking can make a lot of difference to our struggle of what unhappiness we have. You know, today, whatever work I get, I just feel grateful God has given me his work. Because he is my business partner in whatever I do. And I totally believe that. Because he is sitting in a business meeting wherever I am. And God comes with me even when I am driving, wherever I am. So if the business works out, he is the partner. He will benefit, I will benefit. Is how I think. And it took me little time to understand this. And it became so much a part of my system that I cannot think otherwise now. So it required that effort of shifting your own thinking, that whatever is coming to me today, I get one assignment, I'm so happy. I mean, it could mean it's just maybe 20,000, it could be 20, whatever. But the kind of work I get is only what God gets me. So I believe the work is His. And to some extent, it has helped me. I won't say everything works the way you want. But the fact is, it has, my expectation about the way I was working has changed. And that is helping me with my own, the relationship with my own father, my own friends, my family. It just changes. Because my expectations of dealing with that those people is, if you do, it's fine. If you don't do, it's fine. I may feel upset for that initial moment. It's not that one does not feel upset. I lose my anger. All of us will lose our anger. But you're back. I mean, it was not meant to happen. It didn't happen. I had a problem with my sister-in-law. She said so many things. I said, fine, that was good. Because I realized so many differences will come. Everybody is not, I can't expect her to behave the way I want. I mean, that's how she is. But I have to accept. But I have to still love her in spite of that. I said, if she was my real sister, I wouldn't have thought like that. And from that, I've become peaceful with myself. Otherwise, I would have spoiled that relationship. You know? And it's entirely up to us. And that is where all these things are saying, if nothing is mine, if nobody is mine, whoever comes is your friend. You are all my friends. Because I don't know who is here meant. I have prayed and come. When we come here, we pray. We pray for everybody. Whatever we are here to share, at least somebody should benefit. I don't know who is it meant. Because I am only a medium. It is meant for to benefit somebody somewhere. It's how much you are open to taking and imbibing it. I mean, our role is only to communicate. We are messengers. So somewhere God is using one of us as a medium to some need which you may be having to fulfill each one. You know, and that's what we say, if we are nothing, and that's very difficult. Because somebody says, give up this laptop if it is mine, it's not going to be easy. But the fact is, yes, I will make an effort to take this. Few days I'm going to feel upset. But yes, it was meant to be given away, I will take it. Because finally, it had just come to me for that purpose. You're not able to understand true spiritual practice. And that is why ego and God is not coexisting. If you truly just believe that one thing, one takeaway, if you take back, is everything what I do is meant of not being, you're not being able to get close with the Lord or with whoever you believe in as your faith. Not obtaining the true knowledge without elimination of I-ness, one cannot obtain knowledge. And after obtaining knowledge, the I-ness no longer exists. Now, it sounds very simple, but very difficult to actually implement. Because you cannot remove I from a sentence. And when you say, keep saying I all the time, you're only increasing the ego seed which is there in each one of us. And therefore we say that you cannot attain the supreme state in spirituality. And finally in spirituality, if you really want to follow the path, or if you are already following the path, the aim is only to connect with the Lord. To connect with the Lord at all times. You know, and in every situation, in everything, are we able to do it? Even health-wise, are we able to do it? My father, from last 4 years, from last 12 years, he's bedridden. He cannot walk. He's a doctor by profession. But from last 2 years, we have started having spiritual meetings at our house. I have seen so much of change only by the environment. He still believes because of, you know, I don't believe in God and God has given me nothing. You know, the people get all their talks. Negativity. So when he starts saying that, there's nothing I can do to control his thoughts. But I can only pray that at least he starts getting good thoughts and make the environment a better thing through the methods of what we are taught. You know? And that is where we say that he cannot attain certain things, but at least I can give him some platform of raising